is tics. Tics is a neurological problem of children. It's a rapid, brief, purposeless, involuntary movement of simple or complex tics. Okay. Now what happens in simple tics? Eye blinking. It is always there in the childhood stage, but it always disappears after a certain period of time. While in complex tics, what happens? It develops Tourette syndrome. Tourette. Now this is Tourette syndrome. TOURETTE, Tourette syndrome.
I'm coming along.
Simple is eye blinking, just eye blinking.
It is involuntary.
Yes.
Uncontrollable,
rapid, brief, and repetitive, not rhythmic.
Okay.
Yeah, it is repetitive.
Not rhythmic.
So that is eye blinking, quite often eye blinking during the childhood stage, and it disappears after a few, you can say after a certain period of time, but there is no treatment is required. But in complex tics, which happens in Tourette syndrome, this is a hereditary problem. Yeah, so there is muscle tics and vocal tics, right? So in vocal tics, so many problems creates the patients, like a barking sound, humming sound. You see gruntling and snortings and big sounds, that type of sounds he creates. While here in Tourette syndrome, another is stretching the head, stretching the neck, moving the head from this side to this side, cleaning the throat, eye blinking, not simple eye blinking, but other symptoms are also he develops in this Tourette syndrome. So this is complex, tics, it's very dangerous. So in this condition, usually child feels uncomfortable in social situations, right? And sometimes he feels learning disability. That is also the problem, learning disability. He can't adjust in a social environment. And another, repetitive of words. Suppose if you say something, he will listen and he will repeat that word again and again, off and on. That is called echolalia. That is a special word. It is given here in medical terminology, I think. Echolalia. This word is called echolalia. Now, this is a repetition of words. Echolalia means repetition of words. Whatever the child hearing, he will repeat the same words. Repetition of words, that is called echolalia. This is echolalia. The word, specific word is echolalia. When, suppose if you say, yes, I am doing this thing, he will listen. I am doing this thing.
Repetitive.
It's a repetitive. So this word is proper word, and it's very common after hearing again say same thing and again develops so many problems, particularly children. See, you cannot control this. Tics is very difficult to control because it's a nervous system. It affects the nervous system. And simple tics, it's okay. But vocal tics and muscle tics, that is difficult to treat because there is no any medicines in modern science or in conventional system of medicine. But we have to be very careful about the children because his behavior is quite impulsive, destructive. You see, in particularly this vocal tics. So aggressive behavior, destructive. So you cannot control the child. So it occurs due to some problems in the nervous system or some degeneration in the cells or some problems in that central nervous system. But it's a hereditary. This Tourette syndrome is difficult to treat. Simple tics, it goes immediately in childhood stage, but later on when the child develops, then there is no remedy at all. Now that behavior develops this obsessive compulsive behavior, yeah. Half of them children develops this type of symptoms, obsessive compulsive disorder. So this is very serious. Self-destructive nature, remember this thing, self-destructive. He can destruct himself or herself. That nature he develops, and when he feels some urge, then again that problem aggravates. So here the qualities of vata is aggravated in the bone marrow tissue. That is the real cause. In Ayurveda, that is called majja. Majja means what? Bone marrow. This is bone marrow tissue. Bone marrow tissue. There are various types of tissues. That majja, bone marrow tissue, that qualities of that vata, its movement, chal qualities of vata, moving qualities of vata aggravates in the bone marrow tissues. So that tics problems aggravates. Now various types of sound, various types of noises, I mean sometimes patient relatives can get scared because any time he can develop the symptoms, you see, and anytime he can do this type of, you see, yeah. So here, what we can do in Ayurvedic, there is a good remedy in Ayurveda to control all this mental problem.
This one Ayurvedic.
Yeah. So Ayurvedic point of view, the management of tics, see eye blinking, yes, it's okay, simple thing, but not it is quite often. Simple, it comes and goes, but other thing, vocal tic, muscle tics, yes, that we have to control. You see, so now what we can do here in, there are so many good medicines.
Many patients are having this attention deficit and hyperactivity.
Yeah.
Which I do. They are too much restless.
Yeah.
So it's related.
This is a different thing. In autistic child, learning disabilities and other problems aggravates and memory, losing the memory and learning disability. They can't adjust themselves in this environment. So same thing is here in tics, but this is different. This is eye blinking and throat cleaning. See.
All they clean the throat by putting the
eye. Yes, yes.
You do.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That type of yeah, yes. That type of yes. That is called throat cleaning. But in complex, so many symptoms you can see. So many. Barking sounds like a dog is barking, and that type of big sounds, yes, and self-destructive natures, and yes. Very aggressive nature. Yeah. Yeah. So, this is not rhythmic. Remember, word rhythmic is different thing. Repetitive, off and on. Repetition of words. When you say something, you will repeat the same words. So that is it. Now Ayurveda, there is a kashayam. Kashayam, that is decoction.
Kala.
Yeah. Number one is Kalyanak Kashayam. Kalyanak Kashayam. This is a crude extract of the drugs. Crude extract of the drug. So, Kalyanak Kashayam, then again is Drakshadi Kashayam. Drakshadi Kashayam. And Guduchyadi Kshir Kashayam. Guduchyadi Kshir Kashayam. Now dosage is 60 ml each. 60 ml, 60 ml. This is also 60 ml, 60 ml. Twice a day, before meals. 60 ml, 60 ml, that is 12 teaspoons full. This medicine should be given 12 teaspoons full. One bottle contains 200 ml. So you just imagine, if you give 12 teaspoons full in a single dose, I think next day you have to buy another. So, yeah. Yes, full of course, and you have to give in combination like Drakshadi Kashayam or Guduchyadi Kshir Kashayam, mix together, add some water and take it before meals, or give it to him or her before meals, not after meals, right?
For the duration of the treatment, for how many days?
At least for 6 months period. 6 months period, maximum 12 months period. Otherwise, again, you will develop the same thing. After 12 months, you will become normal. The child will become normal and all this aggravations and destruction, everything will be finished. Again,
some children see memory loss.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, we will give some powders. Powders that is called churna. Number one is Ashwagandha powder. Ashwagandha. Ashwagandha powder, that is 5 gram with milk at bedtime. Number two is Jatamansi. Jatamansi powder, same. 5 gram means 1 teaspoon with milk at bedtime. Number three is Bala. See, these all are nutritive and all are boost up the nervous systems, entire nervous system. Ashwagandha and Bala and Jatamasi is a mild tranquilizer. So calm down the nerves. When aggravation is more, you can give this Jatamasi. Yes, come in, come in. Bala powder, that is 5 gram. With milk at bedtime. At bedtime. Again, Yasti Madhu is there. That is licorice. Yasti Madhu is. This Yasti Madhu is same. Yasti Madhu powder. That is 5 gram with milk. Powder. 5 grams with milk. Any one or any two of these you can give in combination. Ashwagandha and Bala, or Ashwagandha and Jatamasi, or Jatamasi, or Bala and Yasti Madhu.
But Bala is to be given 3 times?
No. 5 grams with milk, Bala. At bed. 5 grams with milk at bed. 5 grams with milk. Yes, yes. Bedtime, bedtime, bedtime. Because the vata aggravation is always there in the night time more. So we have to calm down that he can sleep comfortably. Because Jatamasi is a sleeping tranquilizer. Even Ashwagandha is also tranquilizer. Immunomodulator drugs, immunomodulator herbs. These are plain herbs. There is no any other thing. You can buy from the market and you can give 50 gram, 100 grams. Add
5 gram is one.
One teaspoon, small teaspoon, because this is a children's dose. Even in adult, you can give 5 grams. But dose should be increased 2 times or 3 times. It depends on the severity of the symptoms. But here you can give only 5 grams. These 4 powders is most useful and beneficial for each.
Other company, Mayur and all are given 25
grams.
There are so many companies in the market. I think.
Sir, my question is, why these people are
25 milligram is a very small quantity.
Adult take 1 or 2 capsules.
See, 125 mg, that is 1 tablet.
Yes.
250 milligram is 2 tablet. So, if you want to give 1 tablet, then it is 125. 62.5 milligram, that is half tablet. And now 32.5, that is quarter tablet. So next is, this is powder, that is called churna. Kasha is finished, this powder. These all are boost up the nervous system and immunity. Now tablets, most useful tablet.
Is a memory boost.
Now tablet. This is Manas Mitra Vatakam. Manas Mitra, that is 2 tablets at bedtime. This is memory boost up drug with milk. Manas Mitra, memory boost up, improves the function of the brain and learning disability, because in this condition patient is always feeling learning disability, anxiety,
forgetfulness.
This is the best drug. It's expensive, but yes, once you start, Manasamitra Vatakam. Vatakam means the tablet. See, you can give from 2 years, 1 year, but dosage should be reduced here.
Yeah, 2 years. Something.
1 year, you should give in that honey, and with honey and milk. You have to just break the pills, dilute it to honey and milk, and you can give to that child. Correct? But in adult, you can give 1 or 2 tablets 2 times a day. Because there are so many problems in old age where this is wonderful medicine, Manasamitra Vatakam, particularly in dementia and Alzheimer's disease. Later stage of life when patient feels that See, all this medicine at least 6 months period. 6 months, minimum 6, maximum 12 months period. Right? Then again, tablet Suvarna Mukta Divati. Yeah. Suvarna Mukta Divati. 1 with honey and milk. Suvarna Mukta Divati. It contains pearls and gold. Pure. Mukta. That is called white. That is there. Along with that, ashish. This is two. Mukta the one and one. Now ashish. Which ashish is the most useful? Suvarna anaplasma. See, usually I give in all types of patients, chronic and degenerative patients. Suvarna Bhasma, the dosage should be 100 to 200 milligram twice a day. This is 100 milligram to 200 milligram. Yani, with honey. Sorry, after breakfast, after dinner, with honey, this small pinch, 100 milligram, this much, this is 100, this you take milligram, so very less, so you just take it, yeah, it's in powder form, and the dosage is 200 milligram per day, so 1 gram will cost you around 7 to 9,000 rupees. This medicine is very costly, yes. But yes, it works, I mean, wonderfully. I mean, you can see the miracle. After a few months, lot of changes you can see in the behaviors and using. Bhasma, Suvarna Bhasma, pure and genuine, buy from the genuine company, like, there are so many good companies, they prepare this Suvarna Bhasma, you can give. So you need 2 gram, at least 2 to 3 grams. So 7,000 or 8,000 multiply by 3, 24,000 rupees will cost you in 1 month course. Then medicated ghee now. Medicated ghee, this is also very useful. Huh? Now what is ghee? Ghee is clarified butter, right? Clarified butter.
Shuddha ghee.
Yeah, shuddha ghee. Cow's ghee. Sorry. Kalyanagrit. Kalyanagrit. You can give 1 teaspoon with milk. Or 5 grams. 1 teaspoon or 5 grams, both are the same. This is panchagavya. Panchagavya growth is also beneficial. You can give 1 teaspoonful with milk. Or you can give 5 gram at bedtime. You can give Brahmi also. Brahmi growth is also. Brahmi growth is also useful. Grams, because this ghee always improve the function of brain, particularly it works on intellect area, that and improves your intellectual power. Any two or any one out of three, you can give this in epileptic patient. Thought convulsions, you see? Yes, so all this neurological problem you can give freely, there is no any harm.
This and there one, is NES give no problem?
No, see, those children who are in, who are school going children, you can give freely. Or those who have problem of forgetfulness and weak memory, you can give freely.
10 years?
Yes, yes, you can give 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. oil, medicated. This is Maha Tail.
So massage?
You have to drink with milk. 5 ml with milk at bedtime. Mahamash. These all are internal intake. I mean, internally you have to give. Now, what about external? Externally, we have to do some that panchakarma therapy.
I mentioned numbers.
Yeah. The tamponade you have to put here, a particular oil. You can give after food. Siro Dhara, Siro Basti. This is called Siro Pichu. Siro. That a small cotton ball, you have to dip into that oil and put it over here. Yes. Apply it. Yeah, Siro Pichu. That is called Siro Pichu. But there are two oils. One is Kshirbala. Kshirbala. And number two is Sahajaradi. Anyone, you can apply this Siro Kshirbala or Sahajaradi. Siro Vasti. Oil retaining in the head. That is called Siro Vasti. This is very important procedure. Again say Kshirbala. And Dhanvantaram Tailam. Dhanvantaram Tailam. You can use anyone, either this. See, usually they keep the, tie the cap over the head, remove all the hairs, complete bald, and fit the cap with that black gram paste. Correct? So that oil cannot come down. And they pour the oil over the cap, over the head. At least 2 liter to 3 liters oil. Minimum 2 to 3 liters oil is required. It's a big size. No? That over the head, the fix up. And Siro Basti, it's a 1 hour procedure. This Siro Basti is Kshirbala or Dhanvantaram Tailam. Do. Again that Mahamasha Tailam. And Nirgundi Tailam. Two drops in each nostril Here same 2 drops. 2 drops in each nostril. Twice a day. Nasya. Right? It goes there. Yeah, it works. This Mahamash Tailam and it, only 2 drops. Just tilt the neck and keep it down for 5 minutes and take the dropper and add 2 drops like that. At least 5 minutes you keep there. Whatever the oil comes in the throat, spit it out. That's it. Only 2 times, morning and evening. This is also helpful in Parkinson's disorders and other problem, because if you give, head tremors will stop permanently. Parkinson's patients, head tremors is always there. Hand tremors and head tremors.
Like shaking.
Yeah, shaking hands. Yes. So,
it's the
age-related degenerative degeneration in the ganglia and very less dopamine level in that basal ganglia. So Mahamas tail you can give or Nirgundi tailam. And nutritive, last is nutritive tonic. That is medicated jam. This is Ashwagandhadi Rashayanam. Ashwagandhadi Rashayanam. Ten grams twice a day. With milk. Or 2 teaspoon full. Ashwagandhadi Rasayanam is also good for, yes, all the nervous system. You can give 2 teaspoon full with milk. This is a nutritive, like Ashwagandha powder, Bala powder.
This one little sweet.
Yeah. So you can give this. Okay, so this
milk,
yes, preferably with milk. So this is the management of tics, and this is totally nervous system related disease, like other disease, Parkinson's, epilepsies, and but this is children's disease. So usually when patient comes, doc, my child is suffering from this type of behavior and irritating and kicking and hitting and jerking, and you see that type of complaint when patient's mother, patient can't speak, the child can't speak, but that mother just describing all this problem. So at that time you can give all this, finish, problem will be solved forever. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you,
okay.
Sir.